the conflict between knowledge and reason. Act knowledge mentis. Are you going to take a centi-mental journey? Knowledge is something the mind should not be without. However, it must not exist to the exclusion of the natural capacity of the person to arrive at levels of understanding. Therefore, there is a greater application rarely entertained in this mundane existence, and that is the capacity to balance those belligerents until they work together to achieve a more powerful alliance. It seems here I speak against knowledge, but what I describe is the ignorance of those who seek only power in how, throughout the failure of history, they have gone about to acquire it. In our age, people have come to glorify education as if it were a means to an end and a cure to all ills. In the gold rush, no one has paused to look at the ill effect the imagined cure and the institution has had on the recent events of history. What good is a paycheck in the face of a flunked destiny? People matriculate from the institution, having acquired nothing more with their diploma than a mental handicap. Students of what has passed, no visionary among them, they lack the mind for it. People, this is not the way to learn. Study the workings of the mind and you will notice such a greater capability than the functions of modern education allow that will astound you. The techniques of the Institute are based on pure guesswork and not in accordance with the natural laws under which the mind of any creature works. With the right techniques, a person of average intelligence would acquire a working knowledge of physics, anatomy, and chemistry in a couple of weeks. Something that takes the gifted student of today 8 years and a decade of indebtedness to attain, and that to the stunting of more important capabilities of the same mind. In short, though the student retains an adequate percentage of the curriculum, he or she seriously lacks the ability to use it. I'm telling you this because I have touched on it. I've returned to relate to you that the mind, your mind, has incredible capabilities. When once lost to those prurient dignitaries, those sophists, as Aristotle described them, can never be regained. Better a sophomore than a sophist. Better a Socrates who admits to knowing nothing, who finds the strength to stand against the tide of those arrogant know-it-alls who counted him a fool. Next time you seek institutionalism, read the label. Read the label. The warning label. Then, go ahead. I suppose you're the type that only wants to seem learned. After all, When you get in trouble for what you truly lack, you can always just cook the books like your predecessors. Nobody will notice. They're all just as self-retarded as you desire to become. A clubhouse of self-inflicted imbeciles. Oh, do you think I look down on you? I mourn you. Still respecting what you were as a child. That beautiful little resplendent being, that mind full of potential, soon to be lobotomized by the persuasion of the institutes of learning, that could still remember its origin before the oblivion of forgetfulness invaded that mind as it snipped away at the unused portions, dissuading them. Left behind, I theorize. Left behind, as I theorize. Left behind is a stream of urine in its past, finally removed from the body by its kidneys, presuming it to be poison. There is no kidney to firewall the invasion of the institution's hackers waiting down the road for another poor sucker.